can outrun God's I'm praying that God gives you everything that you've been asking Him for that aligns with the Word of God. Amen. Praise the Lord. We don't have much time, but I want to share with you, amen, what the Lord has given me tonight for this house. If you would open up your Bibles and stand with me, turn to the book of Philippians chapter 2. Philippians chapter 2. Amen. Verses 1 through 11. I want to ask you to stand for the reading of God's word all over the building. Please stand. If you're physically able, please stand. Praise God. Philippians chapter 2. Verses 1 through 11. I'll be reading from the New Revised Standard Version. You can follow along with me in whatever translation you have. The Bible says, if then there is any encouragement in Christ, any consolation from love, any sharing in the Spirit, any compassion and sympathy, make my joy complete. Here's what he says. Be of the same mind, having the same love, being in full accord, and of one mind. Do nothing from selfish ambition or conceit, but in humility regard others better than yourselves. Let each of you look not to your own interests, but to the interests of others. Let the same mind be in you that was in Christ Jesus, who though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God as something to be exploited. Verse 7, but emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, being born in human likeness, and being found in human form, he humbled himself. Somebody say humble. He humbled himself and became obedient to the point of death, even on a cross. Therefore, God also highly exalted him and gave him a name that is above every name, so that the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Look at your neighbor and tell them, in 2020, I'm going to have healthy relationships. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Tonight I want to be brief, but I want to talk about healthy relationships. Shall we pray? Gracious God, Father, we thank you again for this Watch Night experience. And even now, I thank you for these who are here. Bless us and keep us. Give us disciplined lives. Let us live holy unto you, O God. Lord, now I ask that the preaching and teaching ministry of the Holy Spirit would come forth and have his way. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Healthy relationships. I've come to the conclusion that there are some relationships that have to end and get out of the way so that healthy new relationships will have room to develop. And even as I search God's holy word tonight, it is the direction of Paul, who is now in a Philippian jail, that he is still full of joy. And in Philippians chapter 2, really does not begin in Philippians chapter 2, but the content that leads us to the context really starts out in Philippians chapter 1 that hinges itself on the book of Acts chapter 16. You know the story. In the book of Acts chapter 16, there was a young maiden, if you will, who often would follow Paul and Barnabas as they were doing ministry in Philippi. And as this young girl was following them, she had a spirit, a demonic spirit. Some suggest that this spirit had the gift of ventriloquism. It gives the picture of one who has his hand up one's back and moves and manipulates the mouth. It is one who has the ability to cast or throw a voice. I want to suggest to you that whenever you are moved by anybody else, can I suggest to you that you're acting like a dummy? A dummy is one that does not use his own mind, but in fact, they are moved and manipulated by somebody else.
And I hope tonight that we can all grow up and say that as I move into 2020, I will not be moved or manipulated by somebody else's desire, but I'm going to follow and lead up by the word of God. Tonight, I want to talk about healthy relationships. I think it's important that we take a moment to talk about healthy relationships, because even as we come to church, this community is one where we develop relationships. And I want to suggest to you that I got so much hell out in the world, I should not have to come into the community of faith and go through hell in God's house. That when I get in here, I want to find somebody like me who has been through hell and high water, but made up in my mind that I'm going to praise God and give God glory no matter what comes down the pipe. And so what happens is, as this young girl is following them, she is, some suggest, speaking prophetically, and she has declared that these men are moved by the Holy Ghost. It is true, but it is in fact that she does not have the authority to speak prophetically when she is moved by a demon. Somebody say a demon. Can I suggest to you that we have to be very careful, because the devil still comes to church, and the devil will never show up in a red suit or a red dress. He or she will not come with a tail or a pitchfork in their hand, but perhaps the devil can mount himself in the pulpit. Even perhaps the devil can show up in the choir or on deacon and preacher's row. But I want you to know, you will know the Spirit by the Spirit. Tell your neighbor, I know the Spirit by the Spirit. And I want you to be encouraged tonight that as we look for healthy relationships, the first thing that we have to understand, that if God builds a relationship, that relationship will stand, but it will always still have to go through some stuff. And we are living in a day and time where people will get married, spend thousands of dollars, and only last 6 months.
Y'all not going to help me in here tonight.
And tonight I want to help us with healthy relationships, because I've seen people, deacons, who spend thousands of dollars on a wedding, Lord have mercy, and somebody said it's cheaper to keep her, but I tell you, I'd rather leave than live in hell, rather be wounded and manipulated by somebody who is not aligned with me according to the word and will of God. Here it is, that this woman now has a spirit cast out of her, and as a result of that, Paul is placed in jail. This is his experience at the church in Philippi. When he came on his first missionary journey, he founded this church. And even in this church, who is founded by one who has had an encounter with God, this church has some issues. Somebody say issues. Even on your road tonight, there is somebody here with some issues. But I want you to know that God's love and God's power is bigger than any issue that you can go through. And so by the time we get to Philippians chapter 1, out of Acts chapter 16, Paul finds himself in jail. He's chained there, and he's full of joy, even when he has reason to be depressed. We can learn from that lesson that even though we are not incarcerated, many of us here tonight are still suffering with a spirit of depression. We feel isolated. We feel alone. But I want y'all to know tonight that you are not alone, that God is with you. He said in his word that he would never leave you nor forsake you. If nobody puts you on our knees tonight, you are to thank God that you've been in his presence. Because if I'm in the presence of God, I really don't need people, because me and God are a majority. And so I made up in my mind, I hope you will too, that I'm going to develop healthy relationships, and these relationships have to begin with you.
Right.
Can I tell you why? Because everywhere you go, you take you with you. And if you blame everything on everybody else, you are not healthy. Can I give you something? You might want to write this down. That there are three types of people in every relationship. Whether it's in the church, whether it's in your home, whether it's on your job, there are those, you may have heard this before, there are those that are wise. Yeah. Write that down. There are those that are wise. People who are wise, they learn from their mistakes. I'm going to say something, don't miss this. There are wise people. And the Bible says if you want wisdom, ask of God, and God will give it to you lavishly. Let me say it again, that the first type of person is a wise person. A wise person can fall, but understand that even a wise man, a healthy and holy man, can fall seven times, but he can get back up again.
Amen.
A wise person learns from their mistakes. Y'all got that? But here's the next person. The next
problem. Here's the problem with a foolish person. A foolish person, because they never take ownership, you can never trust them. Healthy relationships. I want to be wise. I'd rather be wise and mess up and know and admit I messed up. It's my fault. And know that God can turn it around if I repent or ask forgiveness from the person that I cast an offense over. But when you are foolish, the Bible says a fool says in his heart that there is no God. The Bible says that the foolish people understand that pride cometh before a fall. Please don't live your life in 2020. As a fool. But then there's this last person. Don't look around, look at me, I look at you. There are people who are simply evil. They are not wise. They are not foolish. They are evil. Borderline psychopaths. They take pleasure in hurting others. Y'all gonna help me? Can I make this real? They're not like somebody who's been in a relationship that has broken up and now they're hurt so bad they want to slash your tires. No. Right. Because I've known people to slash tires and get back with the person.
Right.
But I'm talking about there are some people who are so evil that they get joy in hurting others. And you cannot be in a relationship with an evil person. What am I trying to say? Am I saying if your boss is evil, quit? No, I'm saying no and adjust.
Right.
Are y'all with me? Yes. Am I saying to you tonight, go home and throw somebody out the window, pack their clothes up, give them their keys, tell them it's over? That's not what I'm telling you to do. I'm trying to make you aware of what healthy relationships look like. And if we're going to do that, can we be honest a moment? On any given day, we can be any of these three. Maybe I shouldn't be teaching tonight. Maybe I should lie to y'all and tell everybody y'all gonna get rich. And God will give you a new husband and give you a new wife. Some of y'all will love the one you with. And if God gave you another one, you will repeat the same old cycle because you are not healthy yourself. And so when we come to church, if we are not healthy in Christ, we bring all of that unhealthy spirit to the church. And then we wonder why God can't have his way. God can have his way, but God is not going to force you to worship him. They that worship him ought to worship him in spirit and in truth. That's why when I pull up, I put my stuff in the trunk and bring my rusty dust in here and make sure I'm going to give God some praise. That I know when I leave out of here, I got a devil waiting on me. Maybe y'all ain't got no devils to fight. If you don't have no devils to fight, keep on living. And so he is incarcerated. Listen, he's full of joy. And really, when we look at the book of Philippians really is nothing but a thank you letter. He's sending a letter back to the church at Philippi who has sent him some goods. Some suggest that maybe they have sent some parchment, some writing utensils, that he can continue to do ministry even though he's incarcerated. We can learn from this, that even though you are going through something, you can still be a blessing to somebody else. Tell your neighbor, cheer up. Stop bringing all your sadness around me. Stop crying. If I know God, every now and again, when I ask you how you doing, and you can't say good, make something up. Have you ever met people that every time you ask them how they doing, oh, I don't know. And you don't want to be rude. You don't just want to walk away. But every now and again, since you lie anyway, why not lie up? Tell you to be churchy all the time. You know how we do. How you doing? I'm guessing how they favor. No, you ain't. I heard y'all arguing in the parking lot. You ain't blessing how they favor. Have you ever seen people who got a church response for everything? And what we need to learn is how to be real with our stuff. I had a bad day, but God's going to turn it around. I don't have no money in my pocket, but I believe in God for his favor. I'm sick in my body, but I believe in God to touch me. I want to pass. pastor some people who got hope. I want to pastor some people who can speak things that are not as though they were. Well, pastor, it ain't good, but it is getting ready to get better. Y'all not hearing me. You want to declare that thing. God knows I don't have everything that I want, but it's on the way. I'm going to give you a chance to put that in the atmosphere.
Change your